behemoth.
Who'd be mad enough to tame such a beast?
Conjure a ward!
Joshua!
Desperate times.
Drive, no!
Trust me. I'm your shield, remember?
Brother. fight together.
Quickly, before we're cut off for good.
If it is like the others, the entrance to the inner sanctum will be at the foot of the crystal. We're almost there.
Yeah!
It's over!
Over here! To me, boys! Three bubbles! Get him!
Enough!
Once we step onto that bridge, we'll be easy targets.
Then we better move quickly.
Thank you.
don't see any other way.
Focus, Joshua. We're not done yet. This one.
Enough. The army's here. Stand back, Joshua. I'm summoning Ifrit.
Stop, Clive. You mustn't. We still have a long way to go. If you tap your strength here, you'll have none left to destroy the heart.
Then you'd rather die?
Surprised to see us.
How did you?
Gav. He told us exactly where you'd be. Even sniffed out a crack in the castle wall. And when we saw the heavens come crashing down, we had no choice but to believe him. It's been quite a day.
To what do we owe this honor?
A debt I would see repaid. Prince Dion. It's good to see you well. So, this must be Ifrit. Your uncle bade me give you a message. Listen to your heart, and guide your steel true. Your father would expect no less. That is all. Thank you.
For everything, Your Highness.
Dion, please.
You do realize the only thing we've freed so far is this wall from its foundations, right? Now, if your lord and ladyship's quite finished...
Well said, Gaff. We have work to do.
You want us to make you something? Done then, no. Anything else I can make for you? Is there out else you need?
Uh, I don't. Here you go. Thank you.
Is there how else you need?
I don't. Here you go. Thank you. How else I can do for you?
We need only endure this final trial, and we shall. Together.
You all know what it is that awaits us beyond this gate. And we shall face it together.
Aye.
It seems our host would rather we remain. I will stay them.
We will stay them. Go!
Just don't keep us waiting.
Thank you. Joshua! Joshua! Wake up!
Clive, is that you? This isn't stone here.
Welcome to our darkness. A rift between worlds wherein your kind might reflect.
Show yourself!
Grave and many are the sins of man. have you know them? All of them. As fate has seen fit to deliver you home, consider this our welcoming gift.
It would seem we are trapped.
And the only way out is through Ultima. We find him, and we leave.
If you are to comprehend the full extent of your transgressions, we must go back to the beginning. When the world was still young, we visited upon it a miracle, magic, and in its light did all life flourish. For this boon would prove heavy. A pall descended upon the land, painting the horizon black as night. Though we labored to forestall its spread, in this one endeavor we stood powerless. And so we fled, that we might endure. Endure, that we might discover a means of salvation.
It was magic that caused the blight. What of the Mother Crystals?
I expect he'll tell us soon enough.
Salvation, alas, was not readily to be had. First, we would require a land unvisited by the stain of corruption. An unprecedented journey lay before us, one beyond the limits of our fleshly bodies. And so we cast them off. Thus stripped to our very spirit, did we find our new paradise. A land as pure as driven snow, Valisthea. There would the true work begin, for the black crept yet behind us. And soon did we arrive at a solution, the illness having spread to every organ. There was but one escape from this fate. To start afresh.
With a new world. one for which Barnabas labored. A paradise free from the blight where his God awaits. And where, if we only forfeit our wills and abandon everything we hold dear, humanity can join him. So, Ultima would have us follow in the footsteps of the king.
And follow we shall. For now.
To forge a new world would require not only power, but a constitution strong enough to wield it. Acquiring the first would be simple. Untouched by the blight, Valisthea was replete with ether, and we had only to place jewels in her crown to claim it. Acquiring the second, however, demanded creativity. And so I cast forth the seeds of humanity.
You created us.
Is that not what gods do? We sowed the seeds for you, Muthos, all that you might one day blossom. And our future thus secured, we thought to slumber, though that would prove a grave mistake. For it was as we slept that man committed his greatest sin. He awoke. Alone in a world. Left of his god's radiance, he stumbled blindly, desperate for guidance. Finding no light, he sought to kindle his own. And from that single errant impulse was his will born. Having discovered himself at last, man turned his eyes inward and found he desired evermore that which only magic might afford. So wars were waged and brothers slain for custody over that dwindling resource, and the land, she wept tears of black.
He would condemn us for this. Surely he cannot be so blind to his own hypocrisy.
Not blind, just unwilling to admit the truth. Though we're one and the same.
Thank you.
freed, or what's left of him.
Long have our ashes lain cold for want of a spark. Cast your eyes upon them and see what you must become. Valisthea cannot endure a second claim upon her being. The avarice of man drives her ever closer to destruction. But she may yet be saved. By you. It is what you were born to do. Why we nursed you and fed you as your own mother should have. And now that you are fully grown, our Muthos, it is time at last for you to serve your purpose.
If our sin is wanting to survive, then you are as marked by it as we are. The fault is yours. Our wills were born because you abandoned us. And now, you would have us forfeit them. All for a place in your new paradise.
Do you imagine yourselves worthy of one? Mankind has no place in our world. Is this truly so difficult to comprehend? We only ever require you, Muthos, when the time comes to bid this wretched realm farewell. None shall follow, none shall remain.
What do you mean, none?
This is our world. Once the land's rebirth is complete, humanity will have served its purpose. Why would we continue to suffer that which has caused us so much vexation?
Because the land doesn't belong to you. It belongs to us all!
That is where you are mistaken. You own nothing but your precious will.
Brother.
I can't do this alone.
And you don't have to.
I grow weary of your descent. Now you must learn that this master will not tolerate disobedience.
Suffered,
all fought to survive. This world may be flawed. It may be broken. But it's all we have. And if we can't share it, I see only one other choice. You have to go.
You may have created us, Ultima. But it's time we lived on our own terms. This isn't your world anymore. It's us.
Bow down, offenders. Ha! guards this day. This chance, and still you would raise your hand against the Lord.
What now? The darkness bends. He means to end us.
It wouldn't be the first time, but let's make it his last.
Yourselves.
countless generations have we awaited this moment. Your struggles have made you strong, yet your soul remains heavy with sin. Absolution is nigh. Repent, and all shall be forgiven.
Tell me, Clive, how many lives have you saved since taking my name?
Fewer than we have ruined. Wherever we go, we leave a sea of tears in our wake.
These are the wages of your will, son.
What good are our choices when all they ever bring, all they will ever bring, is death?
There's no atoning, Clive. No matter how hard you try.
So why not leave it all behind?
Leave it all behind.
Somebody save me. Won't anybody love me?
I yearn, yet still she is not mine. Have I not given enough?
From will is born desire, and it is this which consumes you, rendering you incomplete.
Do you not see how the world bends and warps under the weight of your hungering hearts? What if it could all just go away? Just go away.
Clive!
None of this is real. Wake up. It's time to go home, Clive.
Clive.
That's right. You're my brother.
Brother? Clive.
Once more, lest you forget.
My name is Clive. Clive Rossfield. Look, Ultima.
Even here, the light of the vessel's will cannot be quenched. And the Phoenix, his trespass should not have been possible. Not possible unless... unless he has been with Muthos all along. The mark of the Phoenix, emblazoned upon his heart, made manifest by the power of will alone. The power of creation. Can it be? Are their wills truly so potent?
Are you still talking?
Sorry to wake you, but I think it may be time to leave. This place...
And once again, does my creation stray from the path laid before it. Steeped in conceit, you fancy yourself a god. You embrace Logos. But we will put an end to this hubris.
What are you talking about?
In the halls of Origin, does our true power quicken? And there shall you be made complete. Soon, Muthos, soon you will discover how little you know of suffering. And so the crystals are no more. Yet in their silence, a new song rings. Its chorus building. A crescendo as it enters its final movement. Stirring those long aslumber to waking. And back to their origin.
Bloody crystals cracked. So where the hell are they? Oh, fuck me.
Is that ether?
What in good Grieger's name is going on?
This is wrong.
Are we back?
Clive! Joshua!
Jill! Is everyone all right?
We're fine. What happened?
Too much to explain here.
Mate! We're leaving! Now! Everyone, fall back to the ship!
I will be with you anon.
Thank you. Tell everyone what happened to Drake's spine. And I'm going to need Otto's help.
There's something about him.
Still alive, I see. Something tells me that eyesore on the horizon is your doing. How'd you manage that?
It's a long story. One... Is this everyone. As I'm sure you've all guessed, the crystal which now commands the eastern skies was summoned by Ultima. He called it Origin. Though the significance of that name is as yet unclear.
What does it matter what it's called? Its emergence tore Twinside asunder and wiped my homeland from the map.
Mention of the Dominion spires can be found in the oldest of Valisthian records. But to the best of my knowledge, none provide any hint as to their true nature, that they would prove the horns of some slumbering demon. Well,
the Dominion's demise was at least quick. Elsewhere, the Republican army cannot hope to contain the chaos engulfing Randalar. Canva is in flames, and the Empire...
Our allies are crying out for answers. I've sent the Cursebreakers to give them what assurances we can, but right now that amounts to fuck all.
They wouldn't be able to stop what the skies have started in any case. People here and across the realm grow sicker with every passing day. Could it be that this new Mother Crystal is like the others? That it draws upon the land's ether? It certainly looked that way, from stone here.
If that were true, it would explain the hastening spread of the Blight since the crystal's appearance, would it not?
And as the land's ether slowly rises to the surface, it pools, corrupting all who cannot channel its energies. Arcay above, ether floods below, and in the middle, here we languish, hopelessly entrapped.
It's all right. When we faced him at Stonehere, Ultima told us his true power quickens in the Halls of Origin. Needless to say, we cannot allow that to continue. If we are to stop him, we will have to find a way into the crystal.
How are we going to manage that then? He's up in the sky. And fast as she is, the Enterprise can't fly.
It's a lot to take in, and I reckon we'd all benefit from some time to clear our heads. The answer will come to us. Don't you worry. Ain't that right, Clive?
Right. That's right.
Well, go on then. Bugger off. Same goes for you, Clive. You won't solve anything like this. Trust me. Go and get some fresh air, right?
Thank you. Joshua seemed upset.
What do I owe the honor? So, will it be? Not bad, if I do say so myself. That it? Will it be? No scratches, right? Not bad, if I do say so myself. Should do ya. Not my best work, but it'll do. Anything else?
Ultima may have created us, but he doesn't make us who we are. Only we can do that. And if he would have us fight for our survival, so be it. It's what we've been doing all along.
Much like Ultima himself, it would seem. His new world being naught but a means to survive. And so, we must contend to decide which of us shall inherit the land. Should Ultima prevail, it will mean death for us all. Of that, we can be certain. But even should he fail, what world awaits us? A withered, godless place, where our newfound freedom will most like prove a chain in itself.
Well, that may be, but a chain can always be broken. As long as one has the will to break it, it won't be easy. It may take generations, centuries of suffering. And that is if everyone plays their part. But it will happen. And when it does, it will be on our terms. That is the world that awaits us.
Indeed. And what better world could one wish for?
But first, we have to reach that crystal.
Then it's a good thing I have wings.
You can barely stand, let alone fly. And only the Founder knows what horrors await in those skies. Are you certain about this?
Am I certain? I am the Phoenix. I will do what I must. This is our fight. Remember?
All right. I yield. But only what you must, yes? I am still your sworn shield.
That you are.
And what of my wings? Lest you forget, you go to stand against a god. I would not have you succumb to fatigue before the fight begins. Ifrit. Your brother mentioned that some few of the dominants who had lost their power to you were still able to prime. Is that true?
It is. But their icons no longer submitted to their will.
Then mine will have to be stronger. That you both might save your strength for the battle to come.
You don't have to do this.
If you do, there's a chance you might lose all you have left.
And what have I but regret? My life ended in the Dominion. I fear death no more. Besides, I would have words with Ultima. He has much to answer for.
We are in your debt, Dion.
We can speak of debts when this is over.
He speaks like a man who knows he's not coming back. And has come to terms with that.
That doesn't mean that we have to, does it, Clive?
Time to talk to Jill. I only hope she understands.
come to wish on a star.
That might not be such a bad idea. This is it, Jill. You know what I have to do. Why I have to do it. There's no turning back now. This is where our journey was leading us. Where it will end, for better or worse.
I could pray to Metia for you. But you'll be all right, won't you, Clive? You always are.
I did promise we'd watch the moon together.
I'll be waiting.
Is it this time, Torgal? Something tells me this is no mere adventure story. We must but wet. Of course not. As long as it would you. Reach. I don't suppose they could have chosen somewhere closer.
Welcome to the Patron's Whisper. Here's everything we've received and everything promised. Come again. I may have more for you.
Vivian.
Thank you. It's a new... not let them be forgotten.
What is it? What do you see out there? I never did ask where you got that anklet of yours.
From Sid, that's why. On the day brought him home.
That long ago.
And you're only thinking to ask this now? Sid saw that the pup had a habit of gnawing on his leg, since you ask. Clap that there iron on him to keep him from doing it.
What was wrong, boy?
Heartache, like as not. Must have been hard on the poor whelp losing his loving masters at such a young age. Doubly hard in being a frost wolf, torn away from his icons and all. Sid would always tell him, you want my iron gone, you find what it is you're looking for. I reckon what he was looking for was you.
I'm sorry, Torgal. Sorry for making you wait so long. Let's get that thing off you.
Doesn't sound like he wants it off.
Indeed. You miss Sid as much as the rest of us, don't you? You want me to go with you somewhere?
Quick, aren't you? Glad you've been paying attention.
Not nearly as much as you have, Lady Karen.
Aye, good thing and all. It's not like Gav would have kept him in nuts and rummed his belly these past 10 summers.
Your kindness is appreciated. You've been a good friend to him.
Only because he doesn't talk back like the rest of you. Go on now.
Where to then, Torgal?
Say what you will. Lady Karen has seen her.
Thank you. you suppose it's magic keeping the thing afloat?
What else could it be? Has Midadol mentioned a new project?
Whatever should I write next?
A love story, perhaps?
I should speak with one of the curse breakers before I set off for Old Hill. See if I can't find this bone while I'm there as well. Here, after all these years, a lot smaller than I remember, and you're a lot bigger. You might have to swim, boy. I wasn't being serious.
You two go on without me. I doubt that boat will hold a third.
If you're sure, we won't be long. Hop in, boy. Rookery's right through those trees. Come on. Race you there? I bet I could still beat you. Here we are. This was our hideaway. Wasn't it, Torkoal? Coming here helped me to forget who I was. Or wasn't. Prince. Shield. Son his mother could love. Had I been any one of those things? Perhaps. What is it, boy? This is all from the castle. And Phoenix Gate. Did you bring these here? My sparring sword. Well, well. You never stopped looking for me, did you, boy? Thank you, Torkoal. For never giving up. For never forgetting. Let's take this with us, shall we? So I don't forget either. That's not the way back to the boat, Torkoal. All right, I'm coming. I think I know where we're going. People always talk about the importance of putting the past behind you. But without it, we wouldn't be who we are today. And we certainly couldn't steer our way to a better tomorrow. Come on, Torkoal. Let's go home. Sorry for the wait. We're ready. Mid-Zoil. After what happened here, it's a miracle there was any left at all. This should be enough.
Let's go.
Here we are again. Karava, if you were a tortoise, Torgo, where would you hide? You deserve a rest. Looks like we found him. Materials to Mid so she can finish her prototype.
You're correct, sir. Yeah. If you...
An inheritance.
What is that? But with Sparty... But what may have done...
Thanks, sir.
Your father.
If you
and my husband. An auntie lucky, but it was this that we but you and I.
Thank what was of
God you would if we do at least.
Titan's Wake is to the south of here. But must not be hasty. The good lady has been disappointed once already.
After. Thank you for the deer leg, mister.
Lord, what is what? No, no.
But Ash is a big
if you go.
Is-
if this new faith really is an offshoot of the Circle of Man.
Joshua.
There it is.
The House Rossfield.
I expect Lady Godotha will know.
Mm.
The bands suit that must be it. Let me what my your thing back and I
think. Come on, Clive.
Why the hell would Victor take the bear?
What do you mean, don't jump to conclusions?
Thank you. Of course. Thank you, Clive.
Loop!
What is it?
There's the leap.
Third, the cat.
Well, yes.
Clive, the chip. Helen.
To listen to me. Coming. You need to evacuate.
Know your place.
Why do they always have to make such a fuss?
Let's pick that you.
If you. What?
Look, him. If that. Not.
You're making a mistake.
Come, Clive. If our words will not move them, then we must find another way to help. Save the town.
You're right. Let's speak to Lord Ferdo.
And you're lying now.
I think we'd better shut up.
What's Lupo raving about now?
You have to believe me. The Akashic are coming. They don't eat. They don't sleep, they don't tire, and they don't care who they kill. They're unlike anything that's come before. There won't be no parley, no mercy granted! We may have saved the town once, but this is different. I do not ask that you forgive me, but please believe me. If you do not run, you will die. You will all fucking die!
Huh? You'd like that, wouldn't you, Bearer?
Yeah, with us out of the way, your kind will be free to claim Dalamil for yourselves.
It's you who should run!
Run, bearer!
Yeah, yeah. Run!
Run!
Far, far away!
Run!
Just go,
yeah.
Bearer!
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yes.
Go!
Come on, then.
Go on,
go!
On.
Go.
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 Just go! Just go!
Lubor, wait. Someone's coming.
Bearer,
go.
Go on!
Stop! You're hurting him! What did Lubor ever do to you? He solves all your stupid problems and he keeps all of you safe. You know there's nothing he wouldn't do for this town. Who was it who made that cleaver you use every day, Conrad?
And what about your counting table, Natalie? Who fixed that?
Whose men make sure the streets are clean so all your boots don't get dirty?
Who spends all day, every day, making sure things run smoothly round here? And none of you ever say thank you, ever!
But did Lubor ever complain? Well, does he ever stop smiling?
He keeps this whole place going! And you act like he doesn't even exist!
Lubor, we've heard enough.
Wait!
We will not run. The town guard will not abandon the very place it is sworn to protect.
And I will not give up for lost the stores that we labored so hard to fill.
So tell us, how do you propose we deal with these Akashic of yours?
We won't run, but we will fight.
All right, then. Fine.
Gather round if you don't want to die.
Allow me to the ether the un there with the tip of Conrad.
All I can where I make a little less or now.
Looks like everyone's ready. I'd better not keep them. Inside.
This one.
Is disbanded. I should get back to Dalimil and see how the others.
You see that too.
Papa?
What is it?
Oh, please.
Come on. Fly, Ambrosia.
be Rutherford, can it?
Turncoats and cowards, the lot of you! If it's... I don't need your...
Please, Field Marshal, oblige him.
This won't take long.
You're right. It won't. Men, finish him.
I'm hurt, Torkoff.
A little longer than I'd have liked. Field Marshal Havel, I presume. Are either of you injured?
No, my lord. You arrived just as our escort turned on us.
Fucking traitors! I'd heard reports of soldiers in the outlying regions abandoning the oaths they swore. But I hadn't thought the corruption had reached so close to the heart of the Republic. It's a fucking disgrace. Your interfering old bastard of an uncle tried to warn me, of course. My lord, Marquis. Oris.
All the...
I'd have you...
Azair might at least have mentioned where in Northreach he'd be testing this recruit.
And what can I do for you? You've a keen eye. I do like a customer who knows what he wants. You've a keen eye.
I'll be here if you need me.
We'd have our coin, our stock and our stock. Well met, Sid.
All right, Ember. Impress me. Let's go.
come on.
Faster!
These are clean kills. Perhaps young Ember really is ready. Or maybe not. Damn it.
Ember!
Then run!
If you want him...
We'd have our coin. Our stock with us.
This won't be an easy decision.
What does the dame have to say about it?
I would speak with this duke.
Saw the captain just now.
Your town needs you.
Here, my lady.
This is my father's store.
So you are content to abandon...
Thank you. the town.
Call that a test, Ultima.
Clive!
Said to bring our wounded here.
And we'll be ready.
I want steel in the hands of every man or woman.